Welcome to Power Electronics Laboratory. My name is Omkar Vaidya, Assistant Professor from Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering Department of Sandeep Institute of Technology and Research Center, which is affiliated to Savitribai Phule Pune University. Today we will see the last experiment of Power Electronics Laboratory, which is simulation of circuits by using PowerSim software. So to analyze and to demonstrate the simulation of any power electronic circuitry, we are using PSIM, and here we are using student version demo 32-bit PSIM 11.1 version software. So this is the launching window of PSIM. These are the library browsers. Let us start with new project. So this is grid where we are actually making the circuit. The very first circuit that we will take today is single phase semi converter with R load, RL load and RL load with freewheeling diode. In this case, first we have to observe the waveforms in each cases. Second, to measure theoretical and measure the simulated value and compare them of average DC load voltage and RMS DC load voltage. So let us start with single phase semi converter with R load. So let us discuss this circuit diagram. So this circuit diagram is single phase semi converter with just R load. So in semi converter we know this is especially symmetrical configuration. So upper devices are SCRs and lower devices are diode. So here these bridge configuration of pairs of diodes and SCRs are connected directly with single phase AC main. We can also use in between single phase AC mains and the bridge configuration the passive component, that is transformer. So we can use step down transformer. So first we will try to mount the circuit which is shown in this circuit diagram, and then we will study the waveforms and we will find out the performance parameter. So we will go to the PSIM software. So here we can see the different elements like power, and in this case we can see the RLC branch. In RLC branch we can see the resistors, inductor, capacitor. We can drag it and we can pull here, and we can use these components in circuits. Then we have switches. So we are using especially power semiconductor devices. Can be diode, it can be MOSFETs, it can be P-type MOSFETs, it can be IGBT, it can be thyristor like SCRs, it can be transistors, it can be gate turn-off thyristors like that. Then we can use transformers, ideal transformers, single phase, three phase, different wired transformers we can use. Then we have controls. So in the controls we can use different types of modules or computational blocks. In our case we are interested in the sources. We can use voltage source, see here DC voltage, or we can use DC battery, we can use sinusoidal voltage, that is AC voltage, we can use three phase sinusoidal AC voltage, triangular voltage, sawtooth waveform, square voltage sources. Similarly we can use current sources. After that we have to find out the output voltage across it. So we are using certain probes. So probes can be the current probe to find out the current waveforms, and voltage probes to find out the voltage across load. So for that we are using voltage probe. So let us try to start making the circuit with the help of or from this single phase semi converter circuit diagram. So we'll start with source. So we require definitely voltage source. So we'll go to the sources, that is voltage, and we require sinusoidal waveform. You just click and just drag here. So this is what sinusoidal waveform, and press escape. Then we'll double click it, we'll get this specifications, for example peak amplitude. Especially this is peak amplitude. Here we are not in mentioning any RMS value. So this is peak amplitude. So let us say it is 230 volt peak amplitude, 50 hertz. Please take care that this is not RMS value, this is peak voltage value that can be shown or that can be seen on the waveforms. So that is a peak voltage waveform. So let us see 230 volt 50 hertz, and this is V1 as say your input source from AC mains. Now definitely this AC main, that is 230 volt, I will not give directly to the bridge rectifier circuitry. So we'll definitely step down the voltage with the help of transformers. So I will use ideal transformer, and this ideal transformer I will drag, may press escape, double click, then we'll see the transformers has certain primary winding and secondary winding. We know the relation between primary and secondary. If primary is more and secondary is less, so definitely it is step down transformer. So consider that I want a 36 volt output. So my V2 output voltage is 36 volt, V1 input voltage is 230 volt, which is definitely from AC mains. So we know the formula, which is very famous formula, that is V1 upon V2 or we have directly this. So we know the V1 as to V2 is N1 as to A2. So if V1 is 230 and I want, if V2 is 36 volt, so definitely the ratio is 230 upon 36. So if we take this particular primary winding ratio, this is arbitrarily that I have taken, that is N1 as to N2 is 320 as to 50, that is nothing but 230 as to 36. So if my input primary winding is having 320 number of coils and secondary winding is 50, so I will use this logic. So number of primary winding is 320, number of secondary winding is 50, and this is my transformer winding. So definitely my output here will be 36 volt and my input is 230. So input is 230 and output is 36 volt. So now this volt I will give to the rectifier. So now we'll use the switches. So definitely I will use two SCRs and two diodes. So here is thyristor, you take it, you click right, so we can change the orientation. We'll use the same circuit that is shown in our circuit diagram. So this is first SCR1, this is SCR2. Press escape. I want also diode, so diode, press click diode, drag it. This is diode D4 and this is diode, sorry, this is diode D2 and this is diode D1. Okay, now we'll connect the circuit with the help of this pencil. Similarly, this is my output of transformer that I will connect to here. Similarly, this input is connected from AC mains to transformer like this. Okay, so let us name the SCR. Say this is thyristor 1, I will say S1. We can say this is thyristor 2, we can say it's S2. This is what D1, and this is what D2 is. And we know now the specification. Here is one node, so definitely something is wrong, and again I have to connect it properly. Something is wrong, so I will remove it again and let us see what is problem. Copy. Okay, now it's good. Double click again here. this is my D1 actually. So this is D1, this is D2, and I will use a resist to load. So RLC branch, this is resistors. So just right click, orientation will get changed. This is resistor, double click. So this is my resistor RSA. Consider the ohm, 100 ohm. Show the value displayed. So R and 100 ohm is clearly seen. Connect it across load. So this is what actually my load is, resist to load. And across this load, I want to find out voltage. Similarly, across this input also, I want to see how much is the voltage. So for that, I will use probes. So for that, we require probes, voltage probe. So right click. So this dot means it indicates positive. So this dot is nothing but positive. So I will connect across. Voltage is generally connected across the load. And like this, similarly, I will use one more voltage probe and I will connect like this. So definitely double click, this is my input V in AC, definitely, which is definitely 36 volt, nearby 36 volt, that is peak value. And double click, this is my VLDC, this is my what output voltage is, that is my interest output voltage across this load, VLDC. Similarly, if I want to find out ILDC, so definitely ILDC is measured in series, and this dot is generally upward, that is towards, this dot is towards positive. So definitely this is generally measured because current flow through this resistor, so this is my current. Okay, so this is ILDC, now this is VLDC. Now I will use one ground terminal. So definitely from source also I will get ground. So this is ground. I will connect like this here somewhere. Okay, so I have three different probes. So this is V in input AC voltage, that is sinusoidal waveform, and this is my output voltage and this is my output current. But I have not triggered SCR at particular firing angle. So for triggering the firing angle, I have to give this particular triggering pulse. So for that, I have to give gate block from here. This is very much important part. And just we can right click, we can change the orientation. This is gate block, this is very much important, that is triggering pulse. Just connect this. And now we'll double click it. So here our concern is when my SCR should turn on, whether SCR should turn on instantaneously at alpha is alpha is the delay angle, where should I turn on my SCR. So for example, this is what the actual output voltage that look like. So alpha is this firing angle. So from zero, this is alpha, so this is delay. So we can decide, the user will decide the value of alpha. So the value of alpha is that firing angle up till output voltage is zero, because up till your SCR is not turned on and current will not flow and circuit will not make. So definitely alpha can be in between 0 degree to 180 degree always. Ideally alpha min is 0 and alpha max is 180. So consider here, for our sake of convenience, alpha is equal to 30 degree. So definitely this 0 and this up to 30. So 0 to up to 30 output voltage will be 0. So let us give this type of value to this. So double click this. So this will give the name of that G gate for SCR, right? Then frequency. The frequency must be same as that input frequency that you have used. So that is 50 Hertz. Number of points. So this will indicate that in a particular cycle, for particular cycle, when this particular device should turn on for particular angle. So definitely my concern is my SCR should turn on at omega t is equal to 30 degree and it should turn off at omega t is equal to 180 degree. That is our general theory. So definitely number of points will be 2, that is starting point and end point. So definitely let us see my alpha, that is firing angle 30 degree, and it should turn off at 180 degree. So that is positive half cycle. Similarly, S2 I will use, that is 50 Hertz. This is gate to terminal, So this is in negative half cycle, that is 180 plus 30. So definitely this will be 210, means I am talking about this part, pi plus alpha. So pi is 180 and alpha is 30, so 180 plus 30 is 200 up to 2 pi, that is 360. So 2 pi to, sorry, pi plus alpha to 2 pi, that is 360. So this has been very clear. So this is what the gate triggering pulses for the SCRs, and these are uncontrolled rectifier, that is diode. So now I want to see the waveform that must look like such type of shape of the waveform. Similarly, this is for VLDC, similarly this is for ILDC. So these two waveform is to be, this is very much important thing, first, second and third. So for that, press click the run simulation. So before that, before going to run simulation, we have to set certain simulation control. So this simulation control is very much important. How much time cycle that you require, so for that this is very much important. So this time step is 1 × 10⁻⁵, that I will keep as it is, this is default, but I want total time 1 only. Okay, so I will make it and then I will run it. Okay, then one by one I will see. First is input AC voltage waveform I want to see. Yes, it's input AC voltages. So this is from 0, this is to 2 pi. So this is 1 half cycle. This is complete 1 cycle. So such 3 cycles can be seen here. Similarly, I want to see output voltage VLDC. Let us see. Yes. So this is my output voltage. So this 0 to this is alpha is equal to 30 definitely, so up to 0 to 30 degree output voltage is 0, otherwise output voltage is high. And see the output voltage, see the maximum voltage that we have to see. For example, go to measure, see the max. So definitely max voltage is here, we'll see for both case same, that is VLDC and VNEC, that is 3.5 into like this, so that is 3.593 × 10⁻¹. So definitely what is this ultimately? That is nothing but 35.93. yes, so we are taking same thing, your output of step down transformer is 36 volt peak, so it is very nearby, so right, so it's 36 volt, so that is the maximum voltage. Okay, and we can see the minimum voltage with the help of analysis. So but our basic concern is the shape of the waveform, and that is very clear. Then I want to see the current also similarly. For current I have not mentioned any name, so let us say ILDC, and I will make it display, so that is my output current ILDC. And now I will see here, yes, it's okay, it's already run, so it will take as it is that previous name, that is I1. Okay, whatever, that's what, that I1 is nothing but ILDC. And I will let us see, yes, so my current waveform is also same, but see the current waveform, the output is, the maximum output is basically for current especially is 3.59 × 10⁻¹. So that is nothing but it's 0.3593 ampere. The reason is your current is voltage upon resistor, so voltage is 35.93 divided by 100. So definitely, because why 100? Because the resistor is 100 in this case, so it is very correct. So your current is 0.3593 ampere, so right. But the important is, as it is resistive load, so it will preserve the shape, same shape that of voltage or that of input voltages, but up to alpha is equal to 30 your voltage will be 0. So this is semi converter waveform. So this, in this case, if we change the value of firing angle, your output voltage will vary. So we can see this also. If we change the value of firing angle, let us say this will be 100, and this will be so definitely it's 100, so definitely this 180 plus 100, so that is definitely 280. Okay, so in this case, if I want to measure again the voltages, see this. So output voltage will look like this. Similarly, the output current also will look like this. okay, because this alpha is now 80. So definitely if we want to see the average DC voltage, in this case the average DC voltage may get changed. So okay, we'll make our circuit original for alpha is equal to 30 to 180, and this is for 210 to 360, because already we have calculated in our lab manual. So we know the average DC load voltage, the formula is VLDC is equal to VM upon 0.1 plus cos alpha, where alpha is 30 degree and VM we know is 36 volt. So theoretically my answer is 21.38 volt. Let us see practically how much is the average DC voltage with the help of waveform. So again, go to the waveform, go to V in AC, then again VLDC, okay, and then now here it is ILDC, clearly seen, because it has been already run in previous case. So I1 was the name that has been taken as it is. Okay, now we'll see. Yes, so this is what the waveform that we want, VLDC and ILDC. Now I want to measure the average DC voltage, which is this average DC voltage. Theoretically is 21.38. Now let us see what is the practical value. So go to analysis and find out average. So it will give the average of all, that is V in EC, then VLDC in ILDC. My concern is VLDC. So VLDC is my average DC voltage. So if you see, then we can find it's 21.34, and my theoretically is 21.38. So very, very nearer. So this is my first turn, or this is my first reading. So I have compared theoretical value with simulated value of average DC load voltage. Okay. So that is 21.34. Next parameter is RMS DC load voltage. So actually this is the formula, Vm upon root 2 into under root of 1 upon pi into pi minus alpha plus sine of 2 alpha upon 2. So where alpha is 30 degree here. So if we use the formula theoretically, the answer will be 22.81. You can do it on your own with the help of calculator. So theoretically 22.81 volt. Now let us see practically how much will be the voltage, simulated DC RMS voltage. So go to analysis and find out RMS, and here we are concerned is VLDC. So this is what VLDC, and so the answer is 25.04 volt, and here is 22.81. so it's very nearer value. So 25.04 volt is the RMS DC load voltage of such type of waveform. Okay. Then next part will be what will happen if I use inductive load. So we know, though we are using inductive load in semiconductor, the output voltage waveform will be same. Meaning is, this is my circuit diagram. So this is semiconductor with inductive load, that is resistive plus inductive, and the waveform of such type of circuit, if you see, is just like same thing. So waveform will be same, waveform there will not change. Even your semiconductor with inductive load plus freewheeling diode, so in this case also your waveform will be same. So we will not study this content, that is same. Our basic concern is semiconductor with R load, their voltage waveform orientation, current waveform orientation, then the comparison among simulated voltage and theoretical voltage of average DC load voltage and RMS DC load voltage. Now this is what about single phase semiconductor. Now we'll go to single phase full converter. So actually we know already what do we mean by full converter. If we see the circuit diagram, so this is circuit diagram of single phase full converter. So this, from this circuit diagram, it is very clear that all are SCRs. So instead of diode, all are SCR. Here in this case we are especially study single phase full converter with RL load, because in case of single phase full converter with R load also, still the waveform will be same as single phase semiconductor. Okay, so and this theory that is known to us. So our basic concern is to simulate single phase full converter with highly inductive load with using PowerSim software, and again measure the value of average DC load voltage, RMS DC load voltage, and compare it with the theoretical one, and see the waveforms also whether they are came nearby or same as per the theory or not. So now we'll see this circuit diagram. Now I have to change only, just I have to replace this diode by SCRs. So definitely this SCR S1 will be same for this S2. Now I will make the nomenclature, I will change the nomenclature. This will be my S2, so definitely this will be my S3. This is S3, so definitely this will be G3. The nomenclature will not make any sense, but this is for our understanding. This is S2. Similarly, I want one more SCR, that is S4. So clearly it is S1, S2, S3, S4, and I have to use same triggering pulse for S1 and S2, because in in positive half cycle, we know if we see the waveform of single phase single phase full converter using RL load, so this will be your waveform. So we know in this case, in positive half cycle, S1 and S2 will conduct, and in negative half cycle, S3 and S4 will conduct. This will be the waveform that that we must get from the simulation result. So in positive half cycle, S1 and S2, so definitely this will be the same. That is nothing but this triggering pulses will be same for S2, which is same as S1, and similarly S3 and S4, that will be same. So this is S4. Now let us connect this. Okay, let us check. Yes, 3180, and let us check 210 360, right. This is a resistive load, but I want inductive load highly, which is highly inductive load, so I will use one inductor which is in series with resistor, and let us see the inductor value. Say it's 10 Henry, so this is very high value, actually Henry inductor. So this RL load, this is what highly inductive load, and I want to find out similarly Vin, VLDC and ILDC for such cases. So we are not interested in ILDC here, we are interested in VLDC output voltage, because this output voltage must look like this type of output voltage. The current may be continuous and discontinuous. It in case of continuous, it may be ripple free. So our basic concern is output voltage VLDC. So let us run it. So first I will see Vin AC, sinusoidal waveform, and second I will see VLDC, and let us see the output. Yes, so whatever the waveform that I have shown here will be the waveform that is observed, is very clear. So this is what your output voltage will be in both cycle, that is positive as well as negative. So this part is generally called as inversion mode, and this part is called as rectification mode. So this is a peculiarity of single phase full converter using highly inductive load. Okay, and so this is the reason why your output voltage will be less, because this will be negative voltage actually. So this is basically inversion mode, and this is what due to the forcefully commutated SCRs, that is S1 and S2, due to in negative half cycle S1 and S2 are line commutated, but due to the inductance or inductor that will store the energy. In this case, inductor will dissipate the energy, and it induces self-induced EMF, and that self-induced EMF will maintain your line commutated SCR forcefully to turn on in this case, and your output voltage will be negative. So that is the theory that we know. What is the concern thing? Again, in this case, we have to find out average DC load voltage and RMS DC load voltage. So the formula for average DC load voltage is twice Vm upon 0.2 cos alpha. This will be applicable to only, actually this will be full converter. So this is applicable to only full converter with RL load. Otherwise, full converter for R load is same for the formula is same as single phase semi converter. So the value of alpha is 30 degree that we know, so Vm is 36 volt, so definitely 19.84 volt will be my output voltage. Similarly, RMS DC voltage is Vm by root 2, so that is 25.45. So let us see, let us compare these voltages with the practical one. So let us see first average voltage. So go to average and this is my average voltage. So the average voltage is 20.08, and what is my theoretical? It's 19.84, so it's very clear, very nearer. Okay, and second is the RMS. So go to analysis and press RMS. 25.35. It's 25.45. It's very nearer. So both cases has been compared and they are come nearby. So this is investigated. So this is what semi-converter with this is what full converter, single phase full converter with highly inductive load. This negative rectification, that is what we can say inversion ultimately. So that can be removed with the help of the freewheeling diode that we know in the theory. So for that we can use the diode also. So let us see, this is one diode and this is freewheeling. So that will not forcefully turn on this SCR S1 and S2 when it is line commutated. Similarly, S3 and S4, it is line commutated in negative half cycle. This inductor will freewheels the energy stored through this inductor, through this diode, that is freewheeling diode, and the S1 and S2 and S3 and S4 are still turned off, and output voltage will be zero in this case. So let us see my output voltage waveform, how it look like. So in this case, my output voltage waveform VLDC, okay, this has been run already. Now I will again run it newly, fresh one. So this is VNAC, I know, and now I want to see VLDC. Okay, so so what is the difference between this? So negative part is getting clipped, or that is vanished because of this freewheeling diode. So that is actually nature of freewheeling diode. So if we compare this waveform with semiconductor, it will be same. So this is again a very important observation that we have to study. So this is what about completely single phase semiconductor and single phase full converter using different load, that is R load, RL load and RL load with freewheeling diode. Now we'll come to the three phase voltage source inverter for balanced star R load. This is the new one, and this theory that we have already studied, that is three phase voltage source inverter for balanced star R load, and this is what the circuit diagram. And if you see the circuit diagram, input is, this is voltage source inverter, so input is voltage source DC voltage, and we are using three pairs of MOSFETs, that is MOSFET 1 with diode 1 in across it, then this MOSFET 2, MOSFET 3, 4, 5, 6, so 6 MOSFET, 3 pair. But the important thing is the its numbering. So here this is always MOSFET 1, diode 1, MOSFET 3, diode 3, MOSFET 5, diode 5, and in lower case MOSFET 4, diode 4, MOSFET 6, diode 6, MOSFET 2, diode 2. And these is what one phase, that is say R phase, this is what another phase, they say Y phase, and this is what another phase is B phase. So this is RYB through this balanced R R load coming towards one point, that is common neutral, and that is we can treat it as ground. So your input is fixed DC voltage, but output here we can take in a different fashion, like we can take the voltages in between this R node and this neutral, that is nothing but phase voltage VRN. Similarly Y and this neutral VYN. Similarly this B and this neutral VBN. So these are called as phase voltages. Similarly we can find out the voltages in between these two different phases, like R and Y, so that is VRY, Y and B, that is VYB, or R and B, this is VRB, we call it as line voltages. So phase voltages and line voltages are AC voltages. We are not getting pure sinusoidal AC voltage, but different shape. So what type of different shape that we get, that we already know in the theory? So if we especially deal with 180 degree conduction mode, because we know there are two types, 180 and 120. So each these MOSFETs will conduct for 180 degree, and the preceding MOSFET, means next MOSFET, will be delayed by 60 degree, and then it will again conduct for 180 degree. This is the nature. So this is actually the waveform that I want to show you. So this is the gate pulse for say MOSFET 1. It will start with 0 degree and it will conduct up to 180, then it will be off and again start with 360 and up to the next it's a periodical. So the 0 to 180 MOSFET 1, then 60 to 240 MOSFET 2, then 120 to 300 is MOSFET 3, then 180 to 360, that is MOSFET 4. Then this is 180 to 360 is up to one cycle. So after that there will be repetition. So for example, after this, that is 180, we have 240. So 240 to definitely this will be 420. So but here already we know this is one half cycle completed. So this is 360. So again this will start with 0 to 60. So this 0 to 60 again come here. That is the reason it will come here, 0 to 60, and what we can say, 240 to 360. Similarly, this will be delayed by 60 degree. So this will be 300 to 360 up till, and after that 0 to 120 is here. So it is basically periodical. So what important thing that we came to know, in each 0 to 60, in each phase, means in each interval, there are three different MOSFET that will be conduct. This is very interesting, that if two MOSFETs are conducting from upper, then one MOSFET will be from lower, and if two MOSFETs are conducting from lower, then one MOSFET is from upper. So this will be the pair. So definitely this is known to us, 156, 126, 123, and based on that the different line and phase voltages waveform that will be observed. So we know this modes of operations, and we came to know this is what VRN, and this is 6-step output voltage, which is a AC voltage. So this is one of the type of AC voltage. AC voltage will not be always a square wave, triangular wave, sinusoidal waveform always. So this is what 6-step output voltage waveform. Similarly, this is VRY. That VRY is nothing but one line voltage. So this is phase voltages, which are which are actually 120 degree phase shifted with each other, and next is the line voltage, is 60 degree phase shifted with each other with respect to the preceding line voltage. For example, VRY, VYB, YR, like that. So depends. So this, if you see this type of nature, this is called as quasi square, means something positive, zero and negative. So we came to know that line voltages waveform will look like as a quasi square waveform, and both are AC voltages. So same thing that we'll have to see, first of all we have to implement. So go to new project, for that go to switches. So this is what already we have MOSFETs parallel with the diode. So say this is MOSFET, we will take three pair of MOSFET, that means six MOSFET I will take. Okay, then I will use one DC voltage source. So for that I will require source, that is voltage, that is DC. So this is the DC voltage that I will use. Okay, I will say this is a DC voltage, and I will make it as say 24 volt DC voltage, and I will connect these connections with whatever the circuit diagram that is available in our theory, or that is look like in theory, will be drawn here. It is directly as it is. Okay, so it is in, so grid helps us it alignment, exact alignment. Okay, so we came to know that the alignment is not good here, because it is shifted towards right. So that shifted towards left is also possible. Okay, Okay. Now I will nomenclate these MOSFETs as per the circuit diagram that we know in theory. That is, this is first, third, and fifth, and fourth, sixth, and second. So this is first, right? This is third. I will mention them. And this is fifth. This is, I think, sixth. Yeah, fourth, sixth, and second. So fourth, sixth, and second. Okay, so already we have given the nomenclature. We require gate pulses, so these are the gate pulses that I will give. But only thing, that how much will be the firing angle, that depend, that is very much important. How much will be the firing angle, that we don't know, so we have to give it, because for each MOSFETs the firing angle will be different, because we have already studied the gate voltages. So there is something wrong actually, so this should not happen. Okay, similarly here also something is problematic. Okay, so these are the gate. If there is node, means there is something problem. Node should not be there available actually. Okay, there is a problem. Okay. Now we know the turn on time of the MOSFETs. So this is 0 to 180. So similarly, 0, 180, 60 to 40, I have to give it. So I will give double click. Again, this will be 50. 0, 180 is very first, is very clear. Second is where? Where is second? Second is here. So this will be 60 and 240, because each MOSFET will conduct for 180 degree. Then where is G3? Say this is G3 and it's 120 to 300. Where is G4? It's 180 to 360. That is the second complete half cycle, negative half cycle. Intentionally, I have written this 0, 180, 60 to 40. 120, 300, 180, 360. But if you see the fifth one, IG5, so here 0 to 60 and 240 to 360. 0 to 60, that is 60 degree. 240 to 360, that is 120. So total is 180. So we have to see that there are four points, that is, one is 0, 60, this two, 240, 360, this two, that means four complete. So here for G5 especially, this is very much important step. For G5 I have to write the number of points are four. First is 0, second is 60, then 240 and 360. So this complete is 180. That is basically G5. So G1, we have, actually this is G2, I must write it is G2. Then where is G3? G3 is here, G4 is here, G5 is this much, and if you see the G6, G6 is 0 to 120 and 300 to 360. So I have to check similarly for G6. Number of points are 4. It's 0 to 120. Sorry, it's 0 to 120 and 300 to 360. So this complete is 180. G6. Okay, so these are the gate triggering pulses. So definitely these gate triggering pulses will be same as this gate triggering pulse that I should get. Now next part is to find is to construct the resistors, that is the I want to find out VRN. So see, this is one resistor, another resistor, another resistor. So these are the three resistor, let us see, and I will connect these three resistor at one end, and here I will use where is my source, where is source, source is here, so this is ground, I will use this ground, and this ground will be like this. So this is V, this is neutral, so this is two ruts. Now I have to connect these resistors here. So this is R phase, this is Y phase, this is B phase, and I will give the resistors R, say the resistor R1 say 12 ohm, you can take any value. Say this is R2 again, say this is 12 ohm. You can take any value of them, not necessarily always R3 again, say this is again also 12 ohm. Okay. Now I have to find out the phase voltages. So phase voltages are definitely in between the voltage between R and this neutral. So for that I have to use the probes, that is this voltage probe. So I have to use this voltage probe. And voltage probe will be this, positive is towards this, so this is my voltage probe, that is VRN, another one is VYN, another one is VBN. How I have connected is very carefully, you have to see. So one is R, one minute, so before resistor I have to connect it actually. R and one terminal is, so this terminal can be considered as ground, another is here Y, and another is here B. So that is, we can say clearly this is VRN, because we already said this is R phase, VRN. This will be VYN and this will be VBN. Okay, VRN, VYN, VBN. Similarly, I have to find out the voltages among these phases. So again, I have to use one voltage probe. So let us find out voltage between this R and this Y. I will call it as VRY. I will take one more. I want say VRB, VYB say, let us say VYB. So one terminal is to be connected to R, one terminal is connected to B. So where is B? B is here. So this is B, this is R. So definitely I will call it as VRB. If you want to find out VBR, then this dot will be towards B, that will be VB, because that dot indicates the positivity. Take one more and I want to find out VBY or VYB. So for VYB, use here. So your positive is to be connected to, say I want Y, VYB, and negative it towards here itself, and this will be VYB. So these are the line voltages that we'll see, okay, and these are the phase voltages and these are the line voltages that has to be connected across each phases, okay. Now this is what the actual circuit diagram that I have built from this circuit, and now I have to get such type of 180 degree conduction mode, that is 6 step for VRN. Now let us see. Now let us run it. But again, before running, I have not taken the simulation control. So again, I have to take simulation control, and the simulation control will be here. Is total time will be 1, and now I will check. So let us see with VRN. Okay, the thing that I have taken in simulation control, or in this, will be 24, right? 50, it must be 50, all must be same, frequency must be same. So somewhere if frequency is wrong, your output voltage waveform will be of having different frequencies. So that has to be taken care. Now I will run it. Okay, I want to see the VRN. So yes, so this is my VRN. If you see properly, this will be the 6th step. So this is 0, 1 step, 2nd step, 3rd step, 4th step, 5th step, 6th step. So this is one complete cycle, and in one cycle 3 step, another cycle 6 step. So whatever the diagram that you have already studied in the theory, same will be reflected in VRN. So VRN is one of the indicative phase voltage. We can also have VYN also. So VYN also can be seen, and it is also 6 step. It's very clear if you see this diagram also. So VYN starts like this, look like this. So this is VYN. Also we can see the VBN, and VBN is look like this. So all are 6 step. If you see this theory hour, so VBN starts with this positive. Yes, it's correct. So this is 6 step. So this is clarified, this is verified. Now I want to see the line voltages, that is VRY, VRB. So again, run it. So VRY, so this must be quasi square. Yes, it is quasi square. If you compare this with this, VRY positive 0, negative 0. Let us see. Yes, positive 0, negative 0, positive. So this is quasi square waveform. Similarly, we can see VYB. So VYB, and then next remaining is VRB. Let us see. So all waveform, let us see how it look like. So all waveforms are quasi square, RY YB RB. So it's CD. RY YB, it's from negative, RB is from 0. Yes, RB is from 0, YB is from negative. So this is again a quasi square waveform. So this is what the phase voltage is. So the very interesting thing is your input is DC voltages and output is this quasi square or 6 step voltages, which are AC voltages. So truly it is called as 6 step voltage source inverter for phase voltage, or quasi square voltage source inverter for line voltages. So this is for 180 degree conduction mode. For 120 degree conduction mode, we just change this 0 and 120 and similarly some gate pulse, and we can get the waveform as it is. So this is what actually the syllabus point of view, that we have taken simulation of circuits by using PowerSim software. So we have studied three power electronic circuitry with the help of PowerSim software. First is single phase semi converter using R load, especially R load. We can use RL and freewheeling diode using RL also. Then single phase full converter using RL load. We can also use single phase full converter with R, then RL load and RL load with freewheeling. And the third one that we have studied is three phase voltage source inverter for balanced R R load for 180 degree conduction mode. So any one of them can be asked in the exam for power electronics laboratory practical examination. So this is from my side, and thank you very much.